Do you think you have the X Factor?
Oh, yeah.
Just give me a chance and I'll do it.
We may have stumbled across something here very unusual for this country, let me tell you.
You can't not put me through. My mum will go mad.
Where a record-breaking 50,000 people have applied in the hope of becoming the winner of The X Factor. And this week, we're in Birmingham.
The mile-long queue is the longest ever seen at The X Factor auditions. They're all here hoping to win a massive recording contract, but it's going to be a long wait. The X Factor is the only competition open to groups and singers of any age. There's three categories. The 16 to 24s.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away.
Been going round and round, I've been all over town.
The 25 and overs.
Is when I fall in love with you.
It's the end of my world, the end of my world.
And groups.
My love, my love,
my endless love.
What becomes of the broken hearted?
Deciding their fate is Sharon Osbourne, Louis Walsh, and Simon Cowell. In a week's time, they'll be assigned one category of singers each. Then it's a fierce competition to select and mentor the acts they think could win the X Factor. But for now, they're working together. First into audition is 21-year-old Tamara.
And what are you going to say?
Fame.
Off you go.
Remember my nigga game? I'm gonna lick it forever. I'm gonna learn how to fly. I feel it coming together. People will see me and dug. I'm gonna make it to heaven.
You have one of the strangest voices I've ever heard in my life.
It's like you have a little bird or something inside there that's chirping.
Do you not think it's individual?
No, it's odd. And we're gonna have to say no.
It's not been a great start, and back in the holding room, 68-year-old Ruth's worried about something that might affect her performance.
I have dentures in the top that I need powder to stick it in. I forgot to bring it with me. So that will detract a little bit from what I want to give, what I want to belt out, you know. I just hope the dentures don't come out with it.
While Ruth waits to see if her teeth will hold out, 21-year-old Lauren is about to sing for the judges.
I don't want to close my eyes. I afford to sleep. I miss you, babe. And I don't want to miss a thing.
I think you're very good. You're different.
Yeah.
Did you like a show?
Yeah, I think you're great.
Yeah.
I really do.
You're refreshing. You're a breath of fresh air.
You're today. Your own person, and I like that.
Louis, yes or no?
Absolutely yes.
Sharon?
Yes.
You are 100% going through to the next round.
Thank you.
She's very special, that little thing. Really special.
Yeah. I said absolutely what.
And with Lauren through, things are starting to look up.
I'm doing it all you want, baby.
Yes.
Sharon?
Yes.
Thank you.
You're through.
Oh, my babe.
You're through to the next round.
Yeah. Wait a minute.
All right, I'm going to say yes.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you.
You absolutely have more than you even know.
Oh my God, I've wanted this for so long.
I want to be the X Factor.
So the mood in Birmingham is good. But one person who's not feeling so perky is 35-year-old Gary.
There is nothing for me but to love you. Just the way you look tonight.
Thank you. Louis.
Gary, you have a really nice voice, but for all your years of experience, you just stood out. You didn't sell the song at all.
Okay.
You don't look like a winner to me.
I am a winner.
I don't believe that.
I am.
I list you not as a star, as an entertainer. Do you do magic?
No.
Gary,
no,
make him happy. Pull a rabbit out your ass, would you? Then he'll be happy. Simon.
I'm so tired this morning, you won't believe it. I'm so tired. Look at my eyes. They're
we
red.
Are. We're looking. Yeah. So you are tired. But it's a no from me, honestly.
I was up late last night. I got in at about 3 o'clock in the morning. You can't say that.
Give him a break. Why are you tired? The bloody guy's working. He's got a job, for God's sake. Give him a break.
I don't see it, Sharon.
I'd say yes. You've got a yes from me, Gary.
It's a no.
Come on, Simon.
No,
just give me a chance and I'll do it.
I don't think you have the X Factor.
I think I have.
I don't think you have.
I think I have.
I'll tell you what. Come back in this afternoon.
Go and have a kip.
Go and have a sleep and come back this afternoon. Okay. I can't bear all this tired bull.
Thank you.
And Gary's lack of sleep isn't the only excuse given for a poor performance.
Can I be honest?
I've got a big cold sore on my face. I didn't have enough coffee in me.
It's a bit early in the morning for me.
I've got tonsillitis, first of all. My voice dried up completely and I sang it in a lower key. I don't blame myself because it wasn't actually my fault.
Just getting over a cold at the moment.
It's very, very hard to sing with that music, especially with harmonies all the way through.
Having a sore throat and that.
As a creative person, you can't take on something and be out of sorts. It's just not happening.
With her teeth firmly in place, 68-year-old Ruth is making some new friends in the queue.
Have you met my friend?
Yeah, we have, yeah.
I need a drink of water. Only just. We haven't known each other for very long, have we?
Five minutes. Can she have a bit of your squash?
Yeah, of course she can. Yeah.
Squash? Oh,
yeah,
that'll do.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah.
Didn't talk
in an
squash.
Oxo.
He's still my soul. The Lord is on thy side. Give to our Lord. Sorry, to order and provide.
Thank you. That was wonderful.
You remind me of Billy Connolly.
I am Scottish.
That's why.
You're very refined and gentle, but I just don't think that sort of thing is what we're looking for.
Oh, yes, I can understand that.
Hello, Frederick.
Hello.
How are you?
All right, thank you.
Good.
Quick. Even though she's not through herself, Ruth has decided to wait for Fred, and his caretaking is squash.
In your own time.
Kind of magic. It's a kind of magic. One sharp light that shows the way. The waiting seems to last forever. It's a kind of magic. It's a kind of magic.
Well, you've got Freddy's moustache. That's it, though.
If I were you, I'd keep on doing your karaoke because I'm sure you're really good at that, Frederick.
Okay, thank you very much.
Nice of you to come in today.
Nice to meet you, Fred.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Fred.
Thanks.
Thank
you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bless.
We like Fred.
He was nice.
I liked Fred.
He was like an old dog, wasn't he?
Yeah, perfect.
I'm sorry you didn't get
through. You're all right.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, man, dude, it's brilliant.
Yeah, you had a bit of a laugh.
Yeah, good laugh, yeah.
You met Ruth.
Yeah, good.
Oh, Fred, are you sure you don't want these crisps?
Pardon?
Do you want the crisps?
No.
No?
Ruth?
Of course, she'll have them.
See you later.
No waste, dear. See you then, Fred.
So sadly, it's a no for Ruth and for Fred. And it's not looking good for the 25 and overs. But can 50-year-old Linda turn things around?
I'm singing this because my mum never got her dream, bless her, because she died. And everywhere I went on tour, she was always with me. And I'm doing it for her, and she's with me today. I just want to prove that I can do this at 50, that I'm good enough.
Why have you come here?
For my dream.
And how did you become ill?
I've got osteoarthritis of the spine, a crumbling disease, sadly. But I don't let that stop me, sweetheart. That's why I'm here today.
Linda, what are you going to sing?
The Rose.
Go on, Linda, in your own time when you're ready.
Thank you, Sharon. It's the one you won't be taking, who cannot sing to give, and the soul afraid of dying, that never learns to live.
Thank you. Louis.
I really liked your voice. It was very like Bette Miller. But I knew you got a very good, strong voice.
Yes or no?
Yes.
Linda, if I'm being honest, I didn't like your voice very much. I didn't like your phrasing. It was very staccato, the way you sang. And I didn't feel much emotion from you when you sang that song.
Are you f***ing nuts?
I liked it
too. I didn't,
too.
No.
Simon?
No, I didn't.
I agree with you, Sharon.
The emotion was what took me away.
Absolutely, yeah.
I would say no.
Well, I'm saying yes, Sharon. And I know Sharon's going to say yes.
Of course I'm going to say yes. You're brilliant.
Thank you, Sharon. Am I through?
You're through.
Oh, my.
You're through.
Take those two.
You're through.
Are you through?
Oh, my God.
Way! Congratulations.
My God. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
I think we're going to get to it this afternoon, you and I.
I've got through us.
Yeah.
I can't believe it.
Woo.
Oh, my God.
Still to come on The X Factor.
Rowetta, you fruitcake, come back.
To come on The X Factor.
The gentleman there with the glasses, you're out of tune. Absolutely zero chance of you guys ever, ever, ever having a successful career.
The X Factor auditions are in Birmingham. While Gary, who was told to rest by the judges, takes a kip, the holding room is filling up. Meanwhile, a rather epic new group is arriving. There's literally hundreds of them, and they've got just one message for the judges.
We got the X Factor!
And they're not alone.
Have you got the X Factor?
Yes, I have.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay, off you go. Okay.
Everybody's looking for that something. Some find it in the lover's eyes. Who can deny the joy it brings? When you found that special thing, you're flying without wings.
Thank you. What exactly do you think you've got?
I've got what it takes.
To be what?
To be a singer.
No, you haven't.
Why haven't? Why haven't I got... Why do you think I've got what I've got it takes to be a singer?
Because you've got a terrible voice.
Can I ask, have you ever recorded your voice?
Yes, I've been in a studio before and I've done a couple of tracks, yes.
Oh, you have? And you liked it, you were happy with
it?
Yes,
I was, yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Don't know what I'll say, really. He's lost style, not me.
And after that, Simon doesn't hold back.
Charles, me, your working class Barbie.
You're too old to be a Barbie doll, sweetheart.
I was in Miss Dance of Great Britain, 2003.
Whoopee.
Ignore him.
He's harsh. He's really harsh. I want to sing in opera.
We don't want you to. Right. That was absolutely dreadful.
Yes.
What?
How dare you? What?
Oh,
this girl can sing. She's got a great bloody voice.
And who's going to buy her records? It's a no. I really hate your image. Almost creepy. I don't know, it's just you.
Oh, Simon.
It's like the lights are off.
I agree.
Yeah, we're all happy then.
Let's go home to my family.
It's a bad news day.
On and on, I'm searching. Never ever gonna stop. Till I find somebody like you, somebody who knows, could you be that somebody?
All right, we've heard enough. I think you're probably the most disillusioned group of people we've had in this competition. And that's the truth. I think the group is horrendous. You have absolutely zero edge, no originality. I think individually you're weak. I think as a group you're even worse. Absolutely zero chance of you guys ever, ever, ever having a successful career.
Just say what you really mean, Simon.
No, I mean it.
Simon.
It's just a complete and utter waste of everyone's time, that audition.
So, Wired for Sound have been mauled by Simon. Another auditionee whose band took a very public battering is former One True Voice member, Matt Johnson.
after the band finished, I did the whole go home and hide away, and about 2 months ago, I just said, you know, I'm sick of being like this, you know, I went into a competition and I did well in it, and you should be proud of what happened at that time, and I'm not ashamed of what I did.
I think you've been really brave coming here today.
Yeah, well, we'll...
And I wish you well.
See what happens, eh?
Yeah.
I won't forget the way you're kissing, the feeling so strong, were lasting for so long.
I like you very much. Yeah, you're confident, you're good, I like you.
I do too. You were the guy I like most in One True Voice. And
Simon, you're being unusually quiet.
Because the idea of making an album with you, Matt, would bore me to tears.
I think he deserves a second chance.
For what?
Because I think he's good.
You're a nice guy, you've got a nice voice, but so what? You know, I don't believe in a million years you're a star.
I will prove to you that I can do this, because I want this more than anything in the world.
So does everyone who auditions for this show.
Do you know what it is, Matt? I really like you, but I don't know whether I'd want you, because I think what you do is somewhat dated and you're only 18.
Exactly. Matt, I'm going to say 100% no from me.
Well, I'm saying 100% yes.
If you get in either of our categories, and we don't know what we're going to get yet, the first day I'd have you out.
I wouldn't.
And me.
I wouldn't.
So I'm going to put you in. Hope to God you get Louis.
You're through. You're through, Matt.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Yeah.
You're through.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
I know, yeah. It was a weird though, because kind of, Louis was like, you're 100% brilliant, and Simon was like, you're 100% not. So it's kind of really weird.
A sleep-deprived Gary auditioned for the judges.
Give him a break, why are you tired? The bloody guy's working.
They were split as to whether or not to put him through, so Simon came up with a suggestion.
Come back in this afternoon.
Go and have a kip.
Go and have a sleep and come back this afternoon.
After an hour's sleep, Gary's back.
It's me.
You're raring to go now,
okay,
right?
Come on.
This is it. Attitude, come on.
A smile on your face lets me know that you need me. There's a truth in your eyes saying you'll never leave me. You say it best when you say nothing at all.
I think the rest probably helped you a little bit.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's enough, though.
I think you sang it very well.
Thank you.
Simon?
They get it.
Why?
For this competition, you would be my biggest nightmare.
Why?
Because you devalue it.
When I do say big band things, and I get heads turning, and that is the truth.
Yeah, which way?
Simon, why do you always have to take it down to such a low level?
Because
why,
I'm trying to give this...
Why can't you give the guy a break? Why do you always have to have that sarcasm at the end?
I'm not trying to be sarcastic, Sharon.
Yeah,
I'm just trying to give this guy a reality check.
You're the one that needs a reality check.
She's right.
You do need
I think
a
he deserves a break,
check.
Simon.
Do you think he needs a reality check?
I think you do, actually.
I bloody think you do, and yeah. I think I'm going to give it to you right now. And in fact, there's a bit left here.
That's brilliant, thanks. Thank you.
You've got my vote.
Oh, my God. And you know what? You're through. Because we're putting you through.
He's not bloody through.
We are putting you through.
Two against one.
Do you know why we're putting you through?
Simon, you're not in this.
Gary, let me just tell you something 100%, all right? If you are in
He's
my category, you are not
wet.
Going to go any further. They are patronising you.
No.
That was childish, by the way, putting water over me.
Today.
Thank you, Simon.
What?
I've got it.
Over here.
I've got it. I'm
through. You're through. Oh, congratulations.
I'm glad you did.
Actually, that's from me and Kelly. The f***ing glass was from Kelly.
If you give it out, you have
you
to
gotta
take it.
You've got to take it. And yeah. I always say that. If you give it out, you have to take it.
After drying off, a disgruntled Simon returns to the audition room.
Smile, Simon, and the world smiles with you.
I've lost my phone.
No, it was down here.
You've lost your sense of humour as well.
Can we crack on, please?
Oh, bloody hell.
It looks like Simon's finally got his comeuppance, and the next act in definitely approve.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Made up of over 200 singers, Birmingham-based choir for the largest group audition show. All of them are competing for just one place in the next round.
It's time for our super group to go and meet the judges. Let's just hope we can squeeze them all in.
Just myself and a few friends.
Oh no.
Keep it moving.
Hello.
Well, there really is 200 people.
Yes.
Well, and you are a singing group.
Yes.
Well, that's ridiculous. Okay, so we can't fit you in this room, so we're going to have to go outside and do it.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah? Which means you've all got to leave.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Okay. Now I know what it feels like. Right, are we ready?
Yes. You leave the Pennsylvania station about a quarter to four. Read a magazine and then you're in Baltimore. Theater in designer, nothing could be finer than to have your hammer in Carolina.
It's going to be really interesting to see how the judges are going to critique this one.
The gentleman there with the glasses, can you come forward? What's your name?
Reg.
You're out of tune. There's always one. If it wasn't for Reg, I'd be putting you through.
We like them
we
very much.
Them.
Moment of truth. Louis?
Yes. Absolutely yes.
Because of Reg, I'm going to have to say no. Sharon?
Come here, Reg. Come on, Reg.
What are you going to tell Reg, yes or no?
I can't. No.
Thank you very much for making the effort.
We've enjoyed it.
Yeah. We've enjoyed you.
Sorry, everyone.
To come on The X Factor.
Louis said after you left the room, you remind him of Julie Andrews.
We may have stumbled across something here very unusual for this country, let me tell you.
I've got a big voice. Don't say you're not through because you're mad. That's wrong. The X Factor is mad.
Coming up on The X Factor.
Please, I'm begging. You can't not put me through. My mum will go mad.
No way Zach can put on television right now. No way will anybody say I look like a drag queen.
You're great.
You're sailing through to the next round.
Well, the X Factor auditions have reached Glasgow.
You know you'll make me wanna shout. Look my hands jumping.
And this lot reckon their talent is something to shout about.
You know you'll make me wanna shout. Woo! Shout. Woo! Shout.
First up to face the judges is 28-year-old hair and makeup artist Josh. He's convinced he's got the talent to make it, along with that all-important pop star look.
So you've tinted, curled, Saint-Tropez'd. The eyebrows are looking quite plucky.
Yeah, they've been done. Yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah. Waxed or plucking?
Plucking.
Plucking.
Don't do wax. Yeah.
You can tell everybody that this is your song. It may be quite simple, but now that it's gone. I hope you don't mind. That I wrote down in words.
If I was going to give you some career advice, I would say you should be more of a drag queen. You know, I could see you doing Shirley Bassey because you're very theatrical when you sing.
Okay, thank
you. Don't you think?
Yeah, absolutely. Mm? Have you tried that?
No, I haven't. I have no intention of trying that. Thanks very much.
You are very, very theatrical with your mannerisms. You'd
it's
be good,
good
for,
it's
for
good.
Musicals.
Thank you. Maybe one day. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh.
But as Josh leaves the judges, He's not happy with one of Simon's comments.
I want to speak to someone, or else I'm going to have to go and get my partner and my lawyer down here. No way is that getting put on television right now. No way will anybody say I look like a drag queen.
So, a rather heated start in Glasgow. But back in the holding room, there's an air of excitement, especially for 19-year-old butcher Diane.
Yeah, I'll begin to shout, hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Say you look like I was wanting enough, oh, oh, no.
It'd be the best dream that could ever come true. It'd be better than even winning the lottery. It's something I'm dying to do, honestly. Dying for it.
Too many people take second best, but I won't take anything less. Got to be, yeah, perfect.
Well, it wasn't. You have a very weird singing voice. Very weird.
It didn't happen for me. I was very uncomfortable listening to it.
This is not for you, Diane.
Yeah, you've got a terrible pseudo-American.
I thought you thought
accent.
Americans were good.
When they can sing in tune, they're great.
And when they are American.
God, I hate.
See ya.
I'm not saying I'm an amazing singer, but I did have a chance to prove myself in that show and you wouldn't give it to me. So I'm going to go and stick to what I'm good at, doing my own thing.
So, even more bad news for Scotland. And as the heavens open and the queues continue to grow, still not one person has any success with the judges. Depression is setting in.
It's going to be one of those days.
Yeah.
Your mummy's rich, not your daddy's rich.
I nearly fell asleep listening to you.
I don't think we've seen one good person here today. Really disappointing.
On a roof, it's peaceful as can be.
You really don't look right. You'd look yours.
Oh, so it's really actually quite down because everyone's getting told no.
It's a no.
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 All right.
No.
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 It's a no.
I know.
Wasn't he good? Wasn't he fab?
You never know. We just need one.
That's all we
one
need.
One fabulous person.
One person who still thinks he's fabulous is Josh. Having auditioned earlier and being told he looked like a drag queen, he's been waiting to see the judges again to give him a piece of his mind.
The minute you walked in the joint.
Good, Simon, just a wee bit upset about that comment you made about me being a drag queen.
I mean, I only said it, in fact, Louis said after you left the room, you remind him of Julie Andrews. I don't think we were being rude.
No, we weren't being rude.
I mean, it was just...
You see, you laughed. See, you laughed.
But it's just a wee bit upsetting.
Josh, I wasn't saying it to be rude.
Sing the Hills of Music for you. Do you want me to do that?
Only as Julie.
You want to go and put a dress on?
No, not particularly, no. We try and give advice where we can.
That wasn't advice. That wasn't constructional advice.
I thought it was.
No, I disagree with you.
Well, we'll agree to disagree.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye, Josh.
Bye.
Bye.
Do re mi.
With the sound of music.
He was a lousy singer who would have made a great drag queen, so I'm trying to help the guy and he gets all upset. He has a bit of a hissy fit.
This one.
And Josh isn't the only contestant wanting a right to reply to the judges' tongue lashings.
Do you know what? It's them judges up there, they're not. I feel like. They're just jealous of me, and that's why they're not letting me through.
Simon, you have missed out big time.
And the three of them have sat there and said, I can't sing. And it's like, but wait a minute, I make a living out of singing.
And I personally think I've got a very good voice.
The judges don't know what they're missing. You'll be sorry.
People mistake me sort of for Tom Jones. They said that I took it quite literally.
They could have been the one that discovered me, but it's for someone else to discover now.
Scots have decided it's time to take radical action to combat the fact that not a single person has been put through. So they've called in the armed forces. Next in to face the firing line is Glasgow's very own G.I. Julie.
Well, I'm in the army. I'm a radio systems operator. Nobody knows that I've came here today to the X Factor, so it's all going to be a big surprise if I get through.
While Julie faces the judges, her mum anxiously waits for news.
Do you think you have the X Factor?
Oh, yeah.
Who told you?
Everyone.
Okay.
And it won't be long before you and me run to the place in our hearts where we hide. And I guess that's why they call it the blues. Time on my hands could be time spent with you.
Thank you. You've got a kind of a weird phrasing thing you do, which is a little bit cabaret, but I like the tone of your voice. Louis?
I'm surprised you like it so much.
I just like the sound of her voice. What do you think, mm-hmm. Sharon?
Yeah, you've got a nice sounding voice, you do.
Louis, yes or no?
No.
Yes. Sharon?
Oh, behave. He's putting all this pressure on me.
It's all on you.
All right, then. Yeah.
That means you are through, officially, to the next round. Congratulations.
Thank you very, 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 very much.
Whoa, hang on a minute. Did you just say yes?
Yes.
Are you sure?
Yes.
So you're finally putting someone through?
Yes.
I just love her, and I think she's brilliant. And I knew she would do it. I knew you would do it. I'm so chuffed.
And as the day goes on, it's not just Julie who manages to impress the judges.
Yes.
Yes.
I am delighted to say you are through to the next round.
Yes! Thank you so much. You're free? Yes.
You are fantastic.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes!
Sharon?
Yes.
You're very lucky.
Again.
From this dark old hotel room.
Thank you.
I really like your voice.
Louis, yes or no?
Yes.
I'm going to say no.
Okay.
Sharon, yes or no?
Yes.
Good, good, good.
I'm through.
So, from the thousands who auditioned in Scotland, only six go through to the next round. But you never know. One of them might just be our winner.
Still to come on The X Factor.
Rowetta, you fruitcake, come back!
You're not talented at all at performing.
Well, whatever.
Every one of you in there said you don't think that I've got the X Factor, but how do you know?
Still ahead on the X Factor.
Well, a lot of people compare me to Eminem, and that's great.
Finding a young kid like that, potentially world class, that's rare.
I'm 38, please. This is it for me.
The X Factor auditions have rolled on to Leeds. Now, already the judges have seen some great singers come out of the city, but it would seem there's still plenty more undiscovered talent to be found.
I wanna be down with what you're going through.
Vocal potential, very good.
Yeah.
It's nice that you're all sisters.
Sharon?
Yeah.
Oh, you're through.
Thank you.
How sweet it is to be loved by you.
You've made the grade. You're through to the next round. Well
thank
done.
You very much.
Like for a second I pretend it's me you are.
You sort of have something, the two of you.
You're through
to the next round.
Stand by me.
We think you're good enough to go through to the next round. It's a yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, well done.
You should give me some time, I will be the man you need.
Jermaine, you're through to the next round. Congratulations.
So, will the next contestant do as well as her fellow auditionees? I mean, Megan is just old enough to enter and already has big hopes for the future.
5 years' time, I'd like to be a star all over the world where everybody knows me, who I am. Knows that, not just knows me by my face, knows that I'm a great singer.
So you're 16 years old. How long have you been doing this for?
3 years now.
3 years?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Outside, Megan's mum waits nervously.
I think she's a fantastic singer. 16 years old. I think she's got something a bit special, but every mother says that about the child.
When you put your arms around me, I get a feeling that I just can't bear. You give me fever. When you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight.
You're really good.
Thank you.
And you're only 16?
Yeah.
Wow. Are you confident in yourself?
I'm getting better at talking to people because I used to be really shy, but now I'm...
As long as you keep it confident and not cocky because you know you've got a good voice. Yeah.
What you have is a natural gift. What we've got to do now is find how to make you great rather than very good.
You're great.
You're sailing through to the next round, kid.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.
I've never met a 16-year-old with a voice as good as that.
What's the tears all about, Mrs? You're through to the next round. They're blown away by you, I hear.
You've got an opportunity, you've got your life in front of you.
The judges take a break and discuss Megan.
I think it's raw talent, absolutely.
Yeah,
raw talent.
So raw.
And really nice as well.
Natural.
We may have stumbled across something here very unusual for this country, let me tell you. Finding a young kid like that, potentially world class, that's rare.
More and more people turn up to see if the judges think they've got the X Factor. And the next one in is 20-year-old Stephen from Sheffield.
Well, a lot of people compare me to Eminem, and that's great because Eminem's one of our biggest idols, and I wish I could be like him.
I've been demonstrated, protested against picket signs, from the wicked signs, look at the times, secure the mind.
Hello. How are you, Stephen?
I'm great.
Good.
Brilliant to be here.
Why are you here, out of interest?
I've got the X Factor.
Which is what?
The X Factor is looks, personality, and the character.
Okay. Talent.
And talent.
Okay, all right. We're going to find out.
But anyways, what's been up, man? How's your daughter? I know you probably hear this every day, but I'm your biggest fan. I even got the underground doing scammed. I got a room full of posters and your pictures, man. I like to drink that fat. Anyways, hope you get this, man. Hit me back, just a chat. Truly yours, your biggest fan. This is Stan.
One out of four.
One out of four?
You still got the confidence. Looks, personality, talent, no. Stephen, I mean, just awful, really.
Just awful?
Yeah, honestly.
I've been told different.
By who?
I've been told different by a lot of people. What do you think?
I agree with him. I'm speechless.
You're not talented at all at performing. You should find something else that you enjoy doing.
Well, whatever.
How do you think you did?
May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention, please?
But this isn't the last we see of Stephen, because he's got a few rhymes of his own about the judges that he wants to share.
Simon Cowell, he thinks he's it, is nothing but a soul. Lewis Waltz, you're band Westlife, they're okay, you're an asshole. You don't know about music. Sharon Osbourne's daughter, Kelly, she's got more talent than a piece of shit on my shoe.
Lovely meeting you. Easy, yeah?
And it isn't just Stephen who thinks he can rap his way into the next round.
Something. They got the hoodie of tightly pulled like a hot dog daily and nightly.
By the mic and I'm rocking, crowd I'm stopping. Ain't gonna stop till y'all start dropping. I wanna get.
Don't touch me, I'm an MCG. But I might chat for Pamsy. Me, you say these are teeny. Your things are little weeny.
Very clever, but sort of pointless.
Although the judges don't appear to be impressed by rappers, they're still keeping their eyes peeled for talent in Leeds. But this couple have eyes only for each other. Damien is here with his number one fan, fiance Joanne.
I got you, babe. I got you, babe.
I go and watch him all the time, and you know, he gets some innovations a lot, and it's just brilliant, and I love going watching him every time. And you know, it's different every time as well, and everybody loves him.
I wouldn't say I've got the best voice in the world. I wouldn't say I'm the best looking in the world. And there's been better entertainers than me, but I think I've got enough of each to be able to do this.
Well, I'm giving you my love, it's true, so get ready, so get ready. I'm gonna try to make you warm and too, so get ready, get ready, here I come.
Okay.
Good pub singer.
Yeah.
Yeah, very good pub singer.
Yeah.
But I don't think you're good enough for this show.
Why?
Just something missing. I think it's the X Factor.
I can prove myself, honestly. Please just give me a chance with this.
You're quite right, you're not a great performer. You just go bright red when you sing. It all looks a bit... You're like a little Jack Russell.
I cannot believe you said that, because that's what you remind me of. I think you've got a lot of balls and you've got... I like your attitude. You are like a little Jack Russell.
But is that what we want, a Jack Russell?
I can do this. I can do this.
Sharon, yes or no?
No.
Louis?
No.
It's a no.
Okay. Settle. It's all right. Come here. Come here. I got you,
babe. I got you. Very important.
Not quite good enough. They said I haven't got the X Factor. So.
Sorry.
Simon, come here a minute.
It's the way it goes.
No, but honestly, you know how we're all human and everybody makes mistakes? Is it not possible that you make a mistake in your
yes.
job?
Yes. So you live and die by
you
them.
You know, you said you don't think I've got the... Every one of you in there said you don't think that I've got the X Factor, but how do you know?
Instinct.
Telling you.
Well, why don't you let me prove you wrong?
Prove
you. Or at least come to a venue and see me properly and let me show you. I bet you, I really, really know I can win this.
You won't.
I really, really will.
You won't.
You don't believe me. That's fine. But I can win that. I got you.
It's the end of another busy day of auditions in Leeds, and last up to face the judges is 38-year-old Rowetta. She's been working as a backing singer for 14 years, but now she wants her time in the limelight.
I can't see anything. Slacker than I am.
Hello? Creole lady, mama lad. He met mama lad down in old New Orleans, strutting her stuff on the streets. Hey, Gucci, Gucci, yeah, yeah, here. A mocha chocolata, yeah, yeah. Real lady, mama, lie. You don't want to hear the voulet root. That's not just okay. I'm not horrific or... No, your face and rubbing your arm, it's awful. Everybody, honestly, you said what the X Factor is when you draw people to you. Whenever I sung, people are drawn to me, and you were rubbing your arm through half of that, and then you went... I don't know.
Do you stop for air, missus?
And when Rowetta starts talking, there's just no stopping her.
My mum's Jewish, my dad's Nigerian. I've got two Cavalier King Charles Spaniels, but I'm not allowed to turn my phone on to show you. Please, I'm begging. You can't not put me through. My mum will go mad. It will. It's a circle of life. I've got a big voice. Don't say you're not through because you're mad. That's wrong. The X Factor is mad. And I'm telling you that I'm not going... I don't know the song. But you and you and you, you're gonna... I don't know the song. Goodbye. Put me through.
No.
Why?
You're dreadful.
You know I'm not dreadful.
You are. You're quite mad as well.
Thank you.
I don't think she's dreadful.
Please, Sharon.
She is.
I don't
please,
think you're
Sharon.
Dreadful. I think you've got
she's mad
a real
brother.
Old everything belter's voice.
Please. I'm 38. Please. This is it for me.
Mad as a brush.
Sharon, yes or no?
Yes.
Will Louis know?
I would hate to have you in my category.
Rowetta, occasionally you have to make decisions which you are going to regret.
I will never speak, I swear.
You do.
Rowetta,
which is why
shut
I am
up.
Going to say...
Please.
Yes, you are through to the next round. Off you go. Leave.
No, I'm going to kiss your hand.
One thing I will say, I agree with Louis, you are but you can
it's my
sing.
Last chance. No, wait.
Barking mad, but she can sing.
She can sing,
really,
yeah.
She can sing.
I know she can sing, but do you want to have her in your category? I do not want her in my category.
Oh, here, you nutter! Rowetta, don't make me chase you, I'll catch you!
No!
Rowetta, you fruitcake, come back!
Oh, that's great.
I couldn't put up with her, Sam. Could you? Do you want her in your category?
She has a great voice.
Next week on The X Factor.
You can't sing. What?
I love you! I love you!
Don't go!
This is Aussie Sisters.
No!
Please don't do that.
This is my dream. You have to give me a second chance.
Don't do that to me because you're making me feel so guilty.
What do you do?
I work in a chicken factory.
Good.
And finally, the judges find out which category they'll get.
I want to do one in this competition as well as the contestants now. I actually feel like a bloody contestant now.
I feel like somebody's torturing me. Unnecessarily.
Come on! Rain!
Hello.
The X Factor competition is giving you the chance to have a taste of Simon Cowell's lifestyle. You could win his car, a holiday at his favourite Caribbean hotel and £1,000. Every week you can also win tickets to the live Saturday night show, as well as £1,000 cash. All you have to do is tell us what is the name of Sharon Osbourne's son. Is it A, Dave, B, Pete or C, Jack? To enter, call 09012 93 33 29. Or text MINI followed by A, B or C to 86107. Good luck.
On ITV2 next, it's The Extra Factor.
We've got exclusive interviews with all the X Factor contestants, as well as the three judges, and of course, I'm to mop up any tears. Have a tissue.
And next here tonight, being a pop star isn't always glamorous.
I had had quite a lot to drink.
It shouldn't happen to a pop star. Then at 9:05, a millionaire Bill and Bagel special. That's followed by Parkinson.